Energize your game with the Dunlop Force 100 Tour. Dunlop creates a one-piece version of the iDapt Force racquet. The heaviest of the 100 square inch rackets, the Force 100 Tour, features several technologies including Aero boost grommets and Parallel Strung Technology in the string bed and SRX Technology in the grip for a more comfortable ride. The racquet has a 5 points headlight balance, a 70 stiffness rating, and a 322 swing weight. First up, we have Tiffany. Now, the Dunlop Force 100 Tour has specs similar to what you like. The 100 square inch head size, about 11.3 ounces strong. How did it work out for you?
Worked out pretty well. And what I like about that spec is it often offers a lot of free power, and I got that in loads. I think definitely more power than control with this racquet. And at times I found myself swinging my swing path a little bit more spin than I just to control that power. I really enjoyed that power, however, when I was getting pushed back off the baseline. I could swing this racquet through really quickly and get the depth that I needed to get myself back into the point. Moving up to net, I enjoyed the power up there as well. Again, I found myself aiming for a little bit more of a conservative target, initially finding some of my volleys to punch long. I also did enjoy the kind of more point and shoot rather than trying to drop a volley short, because I felt that the feel of this racquet was a little bit muted and I was having trouble finding my touch. Overall though, I did enjoy the power level of this racquet, especially on serve. Just helps my game out, giving me that extra little MPH.
Next up we have Jason. Now the Force 100 Tour has similar specs to your current racquet of choice, the Yonex E-Zone AI 100. How'd this work out for you?
I thought this was a really easy racquet for me to just pick up and hit with. There was not much of a transition period because it is similar. But I just thought it was a very easy racquet to swing and to use. Like Tiffany said, it is a very powerful racquet. I found plenty of power with this one. Sometimes too much so. Felt like I would launch some balls at some times where I didn't think I would. But spin was great. I felt like I was also able to hit some nice angles with it as well. Really the big downside for me, however, was the feel. I just felt like it was too stiff and too brassy. And for a player that has arm problems in the past, I didn't really enjoy that feel as much. But overall, I thought it was a easy racket to use, but just too stiff for my liking.
Next up, we have Chris. Now you've play tested a wide range of rackets, a lot of Dunlop rackets. How did this Force 100 Tour work out for you?
Super easy access to power with this one. From the first swing, I just really found the ball was launching well off the string bed, and then likewise with spin. It's a very fast feeling racket. So I felt like I could accelerate it even when the ball was hit deep to me and I didn't have time to take a big swing. I could really get this racket moving quickly, and that gave me good pace, good spin from the baseline. It worked well too when I was coming into the net and attacking a short ball, because I could get the ball up and over the net quickly and get it down inside the court, which was nice. I thought it played really well with a poly. It's a fairly firm feeling racket, but I didn't really have any comfort issues. And then at net, I'd like a little bit more weight out of it. I played with a Pure Drive Plus, and so this is a similar playing racket to that. But just because my racket is a bit longer, I get a little bit more mass on the ball, and I was kind of missing that with this one. So either some added length or a little bit of weight, both at net and on serve, would be welcome. But even in the form it's in now, it was an easy racket to use. Like, good sense of where my shots were going. I like the pace and spin again on serve. And then even on returns too, fast, easy racket to use. So it was a fun one. I might just like to hit a longer version with this one, or maybe just add a little bit of weight.
I also play tested this racket as well as the previous iDapt versions of the 100 and 100S, and I found this 100 Tour to play pretty similarly. Right off the bat, like some of the other play testers said, I found it to be very powerful. It was really easy to get my balls deep in the court, sometimes a little too deep and I had to dial that back in. I also found the racket to be very maneuverable. It was very easy to generate racket head speed, and I really loved rallying with this racket with my ground strokes. Really easy to groove, and I was surprised that normally I like to put away my balls with my backhand, and I found that I was really connecting well with the forehand on this. Same with serves, found a lot of power, was really able to generate a lot of pace off my first serve and get some free points. My second serve, I was wanting a little bit more control, but I fixed that by just aiming for some bigger targets. For my negatives, I found that my slice was popping up and it wasn't staying as low as I would like, especially on the defense. And also, I found it to be a bit unstable, unforgiving outside of the sweet spot when I was hitting volleys. Overall, I found this racket to be very powerful and very maneuverable. We play tested this racket with Solinco Revolution string at around 53 pounds. For more information, please check us out online at tenniswarehouse.com. Thanks for watching.